Cheese, glorious cheese.
Cheese, glorious cheese.
Did you want that or not?
What's up, you guys? As you can see, I am so incredibly excited. My smile is so big because I have a special guest here today for Team Mowry's Quick Fix, my dad!
Yes, I'm back.
We are gonna be making a delicious recipe. It's my dad's spaghetti and meatballs recipe, and this is the best out there. And I can say that because, you know, it's my dad.
It's time tested for many years.
Make sure you guys subscribe for future episodes. And you guys, we are in this together. Yes. We are trying to reach 1 million subscribers, and we cannot do it without you.
So let's make it happen. Let's do it.
You heard what he said.
Let's do it. Okay, we can do this. If you ain't subscribed, subscribe. If you are, hit the bell.
That's it. I'm so ready to show everybody, Dad, how we do this. Like you said, we've been doing this for years, and this is like a secret. You guys, come here. We are actually telling you guys our family secret.
You got it.
Right?
Yes, and it's a good one. Back in the day, the kids' plates were very full, and I'm talking about their day.
Back in the day, Dad, our plates are still full.
Okay. School, sports, dance.
Homework.
Well, the majority of the time they used to do their homework in the back of the car.
Yes, Dad, you remember that?
I remember it all.
Oh my gosh, you guys talk about, what is it, the motion sickness?
Yeah. Bam, 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 get home, jump up, take baths. We'd hit the kitchen, boom, boom, boom. Spaghetti and meatballs, spaghetti and sausage. Mm-hmm. Was one of the quick ones that we did.
All right, you guys, so first things first, we are gonna start with our meatballs, because it's spaghetti and meatballs. And what we have in the bowl here, we have dark turkey in here, which is the thigh, and we have light turkey here, which comes from the breast. Mixing the light and the dark, this is gonna add a lot of flavor to our meatballs, right? All right, Dad, so I'm just gonna move this over here, and we are gonna start grating onion and my bell pepper here. And we are grating because we don't want any big, thick chunks in our meatballs, right?
Yeah, we used to, didn't even use the grater. We used to just chop it up. Found out over the years, after using the grater, it's more flavor. Adds a little bit of juice.
I absolutely loved when you would make this dish, and I have memories of just being around the table, you know, with Taj, Tamira, Tavier, and all of us just slurping the spaghetti and the sauce just like going all over the place, you know?
And nobody cared, you know?
Nobody cared.
Nobody cared because you could make a mess.
Yep.
You know, especially dipping the little homemade garlic bread.
Yes.
Just right on in it.
We had a glass table. Do you remember the glass table? Why? My dad was in the Army, and so we would move around a lot. But we would take that glass table everywhere we would go, it would make it there to every apartment, house. I have memories of cleaning up the spaghetti and meatballs. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It was always a mess because the sauce and everything was like everywhere. It was like a good time, you know what I mean?
Without a doubt. Well, actually, every time we sat down, it was a good time.
Every single time.
It was never a dull moment.
Whenever people always ask me, like, why do you love to cook? How did you, you know, learn how to cook? And it's from my parents and my dad.
I don't think we ever really cooked anything slow. It was
always fast and quick.
Bam,
yep, because we had to, you know?
It can be done pretty quick.
Team Mowry's Quick Fix. So now you guys see where I really got my inspiration from. So Dad, here we have our turkey, and now we're just gonna start adding flavor to it,
okay?
So we can go ahead and put our onions in there, right?
You got it.
And then we're gonna add an egg to this. And the egg is gonna act like a binding agent so that it binds all of the ingredients together to help us form that nice round meatball. That.
Hey, you remember, huh?
Oh, Dad, come on. You and Mom, you taught me how to cook.
Yeah, we did. Tia the picky eater? No. If I can remember correctly, Tia would spoon it up, anything that was on the table.
Man, the only thing that I would not eat, Dad, was okra.
Oh, you never did like okra?
No!
Huh?
Remember Mom liked the pickle?
I liked it too? Yeah, I liked it.
Gosh, but I will tell you this. My dad, he introduced me to kimchi.
Yes.
I would tear kimchi up. I absolutely love kimchi.
Kimchi
jjigae.
Taver was always the one that was real picky.
Picky. Taver's the picky.
And to this day, he's still picky.
Yes. We have our onions, our bell pepper, our egg. Now we're gonna add some salt here, some pepper, and then garlic powder. I love garlic. Dad, you cook garlic with everything.
Pretty much everything. With the powder, over time, instead of cutting up or chopping up individual pieces of a garlic.
It's quick, too.
Yeah, it seemed like you would actually get more of that flavor. You get that boom.
Yeah, and then garlic powder, it's a staple, you know what I mean? I feel like a lot of people have it in their pantry.
Okay.
So, Dad, now you have to tell these guys, would you say that this is the secret ingredient? The seasoned breadcrumbs, like?
It's that hidden secret. You know, that you want to boast about, you know? When people ask, oh man, that was so good. What'd you put in it? Mm-hmm. Italian breadcrumb seasoning. Mm-hmm.
But, so this adds lots of flavor to the meatball.
And then just mix it all up in
and
here.
And this also helps bind the meatballs together as well, right?
Yes. I'm not sure what the technology there, the word is, right? But it works,
yes.
You know?
Aw, Daddy, I'm so happy you're sharing this with everybody.
Oh, we were that family that ate together.
Mm-hmm.
We sat at the table.
Here, Daddy, look in the camera. Yeah. You're so cute. He's like...
I'm sorry. We were that family that ate together. Did it for a multitude of reasons. Number one, enjoying the food and conversating with the kids, because you can find out a lot
what's going on. And see, Dad, I passed that tradition down with my family.
Yes.
So it's important for us, you know, to sit down, Corey, Cree, even Cairo, you know, she's talking right now, and I'm always asking, how was your day? Because that's what you guys used to do with us.
Yeah.
You communicate and you know what's going on, you know what I mean, with your kids when you sit down and have a meal together. So this is where all of my inspiration comes from, right here.
Yeah, it was all a big team effort and good food. So we always had good food.
Oh gosh. Let me know in the comments below if you want my dad to come back and show us his infamous taco recipe.
Gosh.
Remember that, Dad? He would do this
huge presentation.
All right, Dad, so this looks good. Of course, you don't want to over-mix this because we don't want, you know, the meatballs to be tough, right? We want them to be nice and tender. But Dad, we're gonna clean this off because you guys, I am all about presentation when I'm cooking. I clean as I go. I get that from ding, 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 ding. Oh my gosh, but Dad, remember, you taught me how to clean as you go. Do you think that's from your being in the army and the military?
Yeah, a lot.
So we're gonna put these meatballs in the oven. So I have a sheet tray right here. I'm gonna put some olive oil on the pan, just like that, because we don't want our meatballs to stick to the pan. So the olive oil is gonna help with that. All right, Dad, so before we start building our meatballs, I actually have a little tip. So I like to use an ice cream scooper.
Oh, wow. Good idea,
Chief. And the reason why I do that is because I want all of our meatballs to cook evenly. So you don't want one to be bigger and then it's like undercooked or smaller so then that it's overcooked.
Okay.
Right? So I will let you do the honors.
Okay. Scoop like ice cream?
Yes, scoop like ice cream and then just go ahead and form your balls.
Okay, this is where sometimes you want to just dip your hand, palm back in the pan with the oil. So when you're rolling them...
The meat doesn't stick.
Yeah, to your hands, exactly. How's that?
That is perfect,
Daddy. Is that your
perfect
size?
Yeah,
okay.
See, you teach me some things and I teach you some things.
Hey, but this makes it a lot easier.
Oh, yeah. Hey,
this is all about speed.
That's what I'm saying. Quick, practical, and easy. If you don't have a scoop, you can use a measuring cup. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put this in the oven at 400 degrees and we're gonna let this cook for about 12 to 15 minutes.
If I could add one thing here about this, remember, this is during the week when you don't have time.
Yes.
When you're trying to do 900 things at once. Mm-hmm. So you can do the meatballs real quick, bam, throw them in the oven.
Mm-hmm.
Other than on the weekends, we would throw it in a pot
and just let it simmer. Cook
and let them simmer, take its time.
Let's do this. So it is very rare that we would have the spaghetti and meatballs without garlic bread.
Oh.
You had to have this garlic bread. And this isn't like, I wouldn't say this is like your traditional garlic bread. Like we take it up a notch.
I'd say take it up a couple of notches.
A couple of notches. Okay. So what we would usually use is a baguette, right, Dad?
Yes.
Put them in the oven. They just get really nice and toasty and crunchy.
Yes.
Right?
We're gonna be cutting it down the middle.
There you go.
Back in the day, we used to just cut it half.
Yeah, but Dad.
Over the years, we found out that cut wasn't that even.
You would get like a bigger piece of bread and then a little piece of bread.
Yes, and when it would toast, that end would get black. The thin one. Now what we do is we're gonna open it up.
Yeah.
Just a little.
Oh, that's perfect, okay. Daddy. So I have some melted butter, and we all know that butter just makes things better. Butter.
Yes.
There's never enough butter. There's never enough butter. So you wanna melt down your butter, and then we're gonna add flavor to this butter. So we're gonna add some salt. Here, Daddy, do you mind putting that in the sink for me? And then this is garlic bread. I know this looks like a lot of garlic, but we're going all in here, okay? We're gonna add some garlic powder. And I feel like it's important to use garlic powder, right, Dad? Because it dissolves nicely in your butter. Oh, Dad, you smell this. I'm sorry, y'all.
Yes.
I'm sorry, you guys can't smell it.
It's already paying off, okay?
Oh my gosh!
Wow.
Jeez Louise! See, I got that from my dad. Yeah. Jeez Louise. So wait, there's Jeez Louise. It's all good. And then I'm sure
in the neighborhood.
Okay. It's all good in the neighborhood. I'm sure there's gonna be something else by the time we're done with this video.
Yes.
Okay, and then we're gonna add our Parmesan cheese. Right? Do you wanna do the mixing? Oh, you guys. Wait, Dad, we have to let them see this. We cannot be careful, Dad.
Look at that, I got you.
I mean, look at that. Dad is also the one that told me to taste your food. Do you remember that,
yes,
Dad?
Yes, oh yes.
You always have to taste your food when you're cooking. Like, that's just
the way to go.
Okay, Dad, I can use my finger, right?
Yeah, by all means.
I hope, don't kill me in the comments, you guys, if I put my finger in here.
it's at home, you know? Oh yeah.
Mmm, Dad, my goodness. Mmm. So, you guys, wait till I show you what we're gonna do next. Or do you wanna do this,
no,
Dad? This is your
you
recipe.
You got it,
no, no, you're the guest.
I'm critiquing you.
No, Dad,
you've been doing
guest.
It for years.
No, you're the guest, Dad.
Pour it, T.
We're gonna pour this butter mixture with all of this flavor onto the spaghetti.
Oh, it's okay if it drips over too.
Yes, look at that.
Doesn't have to be pretty.
Woohoo! It is going down. Not only does it look great, but it smells delicious. And we're not even done yet, Dad. Tell them what we're gonna do next.
Shredded mozzarella cheese. We are not gonna be cheap with it. We're gonna load it up.
Load it up, Dad. Look at this. So whenever I am cooking with cheese, I always have to do my thing, and I have a song.
You have a song?
Yes. You ready to hear it?
I'm ready, go.
Cheese, glorious cheese.
Cheese, glorious cheese.
Did you want that or not? I love you, T. Okay. Never a dull moment, I tell you.
So one thing that my dad and I, we love to do is we love to cook together. And as you can see, we have a lot of fun. And a few months ago, we did fried rice with a nice glazed salmon. And then my brother Taj also loves to come over and cook with us. Let me know in the comments below if you want to see my brother cook a recipe with me, or cook together.
You know what?
Okay, Dad, tell us what's next.
We're gonna bring it up,
okay,
the tin foil, and we're just gonna
bend it over
just a little, because we're trying to leave air and a little bit of the tin foil a space between
the bread, because we don't want the mozzarella cheese stick.
Yeah.
This looks perfect, Dad. Okay, do you want to do it this time?
Go for it. You're right here. No, you got it.
No, Dad, you do it.
We're taking it to the oven.
To the oven we go. So this has been in the oven for 10 minutes. We're gonna check this out. Oh my gosh, look at how the cheese has just melted and it's really nice and ooey and gooey. But I'm gonna leave this open. We're gonna leave this in the oven for an extra 5 minutes so that this bread is nice and toasty.
We're almost there.
We are almost there. So we have our cooked meatballs right here. What we're gonna start doing next is we're gonna start making our pasta. This is very simple and easy. You always wanna flavor, you know, your water for your pasta. So we got some salt in there.
Notice how, you still remember this, center it in the middle.
Yes.
Right? And then it'll fan it out.
Yep.
All right, you know how when you pour the pasta in to the boiling water and you got the salt and everything, and you wanna kinda like make sure it all is spread out, because normally at the bottom of the pan, the pieces of pasta that you initially put in first, will knuckle up. All right? See, you have to feather your pasta. You don't want knuckles in it.
Yes. Okay?
Just easily stir, take your time with it.
So that looks great, Dad, right? So now on to the sauce. And again, this is all about, you know, fast, practical, and easy. You can make your own sauce from scratch, but when my dad or my mom would put a meal on the table, it had to be quick and easy. We're just gonna use jarred tomato sauce. We're just gonna go ahead and pour this in here. I'm gonna heat this
there
up.
There you go.
Oh, gosh, Dad.
Yep, you can already smell it. We got the sauce going.
Yep.
Noodle's almost ready. The pasta's almost ready there. We're gonna start adding the meatballs.
The meatballs, and remember, we baked these in the oven, so they're done. And we're just kind of like warming everything up now. Oh, look at how beautiful this looks, Dad.
Yeah, I mean, hey, it's already paying off, I'm telling you.
You guys are in for a treat, I am telling you. I'm just happy that my dad is sharing this recipe with you guys because they, oh, Dad, look at that.
Oh my gosh.
Can you hear that crunch, you guys? Oh my gosh, Dad, this looks so good. The bread, it acts like a scooper, like a spoon, so you can just dip it into that sauce. And that's what we like to do over at our house, right, Dad? Woo-hoo!
Yeah.
Look at the heat. Oh my gosh. I'm gonna add some of this sauce on there. And Dad, so what I've been doing with Quick Fix is I've been starting this debate in the comments section. And I wanna ask you too, Dad, okay.
Okay.
Do you prefer spaghetti with meatballs, right? Or spaghetti with meat sauce?
Spaghetti with meatballs.
Mm.
Yes.
Yes.
And sometimes spaghetti with Italian sausage.
Mm-hmm.
You know, mix it up, or even both.
Okay, you guys, so I'm just adding some cheese on top. Oh my gosh!
Oh my gosh.
This looks amazing!
Are we ready or what? What are we gonna do?
Toast, like toast. Okay. with our guys.
You ready?
I mean, Dad.
I gotta give you a grade on it now, okay?
Oh, a grade?
Yes.
Okay, all right, let's do this.
I like
dipping
it.
I'm gonna dip this into, yep, see? Okay.
It's amazing. And it's actually better than mine.
No, Dad.
No, I.
Dad, this is your recipe. What are you talking about?
But the way you did it, so much flavor in it.
Mm.
You never spend enough time with your children.
Ah, yeah.
Okay? I love you, bro. I'm proud of you.
Love you too, Daddy.
Guys, remember in the beginning what I said? Let's make this happen. Well, let's make this happen.
Aww.
1 million subscribers,
woo-hoo.
Okay? And if you're subscribed already, click on it there. Make it happen. Thank you, guys.
Dad.
No good? What? No good? There's no cut?
No.
Redo?
Bye, guys.
Bye, guys. And thank you.
You.